Welcome back, Lockdown Legion, to another exciting, gripping, thrilling episode of
Nerds on Lockdown,
where we go over everything in the nerd culture. My name is Chris. This is Aaron. Why don't you tell them what's good, bud?
How you doing out there, Legionnaires? Just want to take a quick moment to thank you for your comments and for your likes and your subscription little ringy-ding bells. Appreciate all that very much. Enjoying the commentary back and forth. Today we are going to dig into the perhaps greatest part of a television show. No, I don't mean the credits. No, I don't even mean the talking dog. I mean the theme song. Top five TV theme songs. Chris, start us off.
Ooh, boy, this is going to be a good topic. I can't wait. My number five is a TV show called That 70s Show.
Nice.
That theme song was created and performed by Cheap Trick.
Yes, indeedy.
And that show was one of the funniest shows on TV for a very certain time period. And, man, one of my favorite characters of all time is Red Foreman, the dad. Because as my kid starts growing older, I start feeling what he felt. In that show, you know, and it's so funny looking back on it now. But yeah, dude, Cheap Trick in That 70s Show, man, great theme song. You always knew what that show was when it came on.
Yeah, the theme song definitely led you into what the kind of pacing and the lightness of the show is going to be.
Yep,
truly great category. You may know him as Red Foreman. I will personally always regard him as Clarence Boddicker. But tomato, tomato. My number five, Mr. Chris, comes from the presumably 60s, though point me out if I'm incorrect. We're talking about a kick-ass family full of monsters, man, who had a kick-ass ride called the Dragula. And if you were a fan of one Rob Zombie, you might have seen him bring up the Munsters.
Yeah.
Nice. Now, I love that theme for multiple reasons. One, kick-ass guitar jam. Right? Mm-hmm. Surf tune. Dude,
yep.
Can't do it or we'll get sued. But the footage, I assure you, will paint a picture of one wicked ass family.
Yep. Great, great show. That show was, I think a lot of people thought that show was like a ripoff of the Addams Family. But honestly, I think it was some sort of an homage to it.
It's in the same vein, but yeah. It's not the same concept.
And it was I honestly liked that show better than I did the Addams Family. So,
all right, right. Well, Munsters came later, I believe, right?
Yeah,
too,
yeah.
A little bit. So that probably mm-hmm. helped.
Yeah, Matt, good one.
Dropping it like it's hot. You're up.
Damn.
Bing.
My number four is from a show called Malcolm in the Middle.
Mmm.
It's called The Boss of Me. And that's from the There Might Be Giants band.
Ah, yes.
Do, 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 do. You know,
quick,
that song.
We're going to get sued.
But yeah, that song was great, man. Malcolm in the Middle, missed that show so much. And right. That song was rocking, dude. It was a really cool jam when it came on. Because, you yeah. know, once again, you knew what it was. It was, you know, so, like, hyper. And just like the kids. That song kind of took... That song kind of took what those kids, you know, were in the, you know, in the show and kind of right. really brought it to life, you know, in the theming of it. So.
Right. Gotta love Cranston, too, man.
Oh, yeah. It's yeah, yeah, for sure.
Like diet caffeine free Heisenberg, you know?
Yeah.
Love cool, it, man. Dude. Good selection, bro. All right. Well, I'm going to go with one now that this was a popular song well before the becoming the theme to this particular show. But when I first heard it, it was as a child against the TV show. So I had no idea. I wasn't previously influenced and such. It was just the show, the song. And I'm talking about Freddie Savage and the Wonder Years.
Joe Cocker.
Indeed.
Yeah.
With a little help from our friends, we can do anything, brother.
Yeah, man. Yeah. That's a good pick.
Dude. I mean, it hits you every time. It's so dramatic. And the OG footage of them playing football, right? In the street and seeing the different family members. And it's grainy and whatnot. And you got that Joe Cocker, like, super... Well, okay, that's not exactly... But you know what I'm saying? Like, he came from the, like... He had, like, a lot of grit.
That grit and that grasp, yeah, for sure, man.
No, that's not right.
That was one of those timeless shows, man. So that song fit that show really well, like perfectly almost. You know, and even if it, here's the thing is like, if they would have used the Beatles version of that song, I don't think it would have had the same effect.
No,
like they really used the
completely
right
different
version
scenes.
Of it. Yeah.
Right, right. Another fantastic cover that's almost better than the original.
Yeah, absolutely. Cool, man.
But now we can't use that one eventually because we've already brought it up. Anyway.
Yeah, cool.
But
man.
Yeah, dude. Right on.
Awesome. My number three is a show called The Drew Carey Show, and the song was called Cleveland Rocks. Mm-hmm. And it's by a band called The Presidents of the United States of America.
Yes.
They're the same band that did Peaches, Millions of Peaches. And they're the same band that did, me of the other one. Lump. Yeah, Lump. She's Lump. Yeah. So, anyways, if anybody's ever seen The Drew Carey Show, they know that it's, he lives in Cleveland, so that's why it's, you know what I mean? Cleveland Rocks, you know what I mean?
Yeah.
So, great song. Once again, really hyper and, you know, feel good for that show because it was a comedy. So,
for sure.
Yeah, I love that intro. So.
Serious, man. I love it when the song takes you right to the show, just like, you know.
Absolutely. Like
direct express train, right? Well, here's one. It's another one of my favorites right now. And this is from a 90s era Fox drama. And when this dropped for the first time, it literally scared the crap out of me. I don't mean literally, I guess. That's an improper placement to there, but point being, the song here is so bloody creepy, and then the show delivers every time, and I'm talking about The X-Files.
Ooh, okay.
Ooh.
Yeah, dude, yeah, for sure.
Man, and then knowing that you were going to get a creepy show, knowing that you were going to get the Fox and Mulder, right? You know, it's like, oh, I love that show for years. Got kind of weird after a while, but, you know.
After the movie, after they had that movie, it got, like, funky a little bit, you know what I mean? But I enjoyed that show, too, dude. That show was cool. Like, the Smoky Man was always, like, a creepy dude, you know what I mean? And it was a legit show, for sure. Good song.
Right, yeah, right. And again, I can hear that song now and just get all goosebumpy. Yeah.
Cool, man.
Well played, Mike Snow.
Well, my number two is going to be in the same vein as yours. It's sort of a creepy show, but it's not. It's more of a teen boppy creepy show, if that makes sense to you. And that show is one Buffy the Vampire Slayer.
Ah, the Buffster.
And that theme was just called the Buffy theme. I think that was the name of the actual song. And it was by one band called Nerf Herder.
Scruffy looking Nerf Herder.
No, this isn't Star Wars, Aaron. No, I'm just kidding. So, yeah, man, Buffy the theme song, and if anybody's ever seen Buffy, I think a lot of you have gone back and actually watched Buffy, because it's become a trend to watch sort of the 90s shows again, and it's becoming sort of a big thing again with Buffy the Vampire Slayer, so, but that's always, it was like one of my favorite shows in the 90s, early 2000s.
For sure.
So that song is just cool, dude. It's another sort of that surf rock, you know, Nerf. If you ever heard Nerf Herder, you know that song, but it's, you know, it's a cool surf rock song that's, you know, kind of action-packed. Like, it gives you that action-packed feeling, so it's pretty
cool. Very cool. I'll have to check out some Buffy. I was never into it in the day, you know?
Yeah, dude. Love that show. It's great.
Cool. All right, dude. If I'm counting my numbers right, I'm not... All right, so this next one is one of my favorite shows as a kid, but one of them that when I went and watched back after as an adult, thinking that it was going to be just as awesome as it was when I was a kid, I was slightly disappointed. But dollar for dollar, this theme song and this quasi-crime drama go together like peanut butter and jelly if they were made of techno, and I'm referring to one. Knight Rider.
Dude, solid choice, man. Heck yeah,
dude,
man.
Dude, just takes you there. And
yeah.
Like, that song made you feel like you could be Michael Knight. Or at least it did it. Woo, woo. I'm a little parched at the moment. If I had a little more liquidity in the throatage area, I would be able to.
Yeah, man.
You can just input a good one later.
I met the Hoff.
You met the Hoff?
And Kit at Universal Studios one time. I got a picture taken with them and everything.
Excuse me, Mike. Step aside, Mike. Kit, how are you? Pleasure to meet you.
I was 11 or 10 at the time, and that was sort of when the show was, you know what I mean, starting to kind of wind down at that point. And it was just really cool because, like you said, like, yeah, I liked David Knight, like, he was cool and everything, but, like, meeting the car, I think, like, as a 10-year-old kid, like, that was the coolest car in the world, man.
It truly was, dude. It was like your Spy Hunter reference the other day with the got the rockets, it's got the oil little drop behind it. I almost cursed on the video. Forgive me, my young audience.
Beep. No, I'm just kidding.
That car jumped, man. Like, no other car in the TV did that shit. Well, okay, I take it back. Years before, the Dukes of Hazzard did, but
different kind of jumping, really. You know, that was more of like, I'm going to jump off this canyon, you know? And this was more of like, I'm going down the freeway and I need to, engage.
Jump over an overpass.
I need to put my rocket boosters on. Yeah.
Dude, Kit was the shit. And I mean, come on now. You got Mr. Feeny voice in him, right?
Yep. Dude,
William,
a good show.
Something.
Such a good show. Now, it's hard. Yeah, like you said, it's hard to go back and watch that now because it's
dated.
It's dated. And you sit there and go, how did I like that? But we didn't know any better, you know, at that time.
Yeah, well, at the time, it was not dated. And we were kids and impressionable. And
yeah,
again, it's a talking, jumping, shooting, killing car, man. Like, what wasn't there to be totally on board with?
Absolutely,
You could have. It could have just been him driving around without Michael Knight, and I would have watched that shit. He'd just be like, da 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 da, I'm a talking car, da da da, and just blow some shit up. I'd be totally entertained. Who needs plot? Just saying.
For sure, man. Cool. Well, let me move on to my number uno.
Onesies.
My number one's actually going to be kind of, I don't think you're going to, we're expecting this one, man. This is a cartoon that, and a cartoon, which is kind of weird for me, but a cartoon that, it was actually around when my kid was really interested in it, and I watched it with him because of him.
Okay.
And I actually ended up really liking this show. And the show was Phineas and Ferb. All and right. The song was from Bowling for Soup. And it was just the Phineas and Ferb theme song. I think it was called Today is Gonna Be a Good Day or something like that. But the song is so catchy. You hear it once, dude, and it gets stuck in your head. Like, I can sing it. Like, I'd be singing it for, like, 2 days and be like, oh, why am I singing that? You know what I mean? Like,
small world conundrum.
Yeah, dude. But it's such a good song because those Bowling for Soup songs are really catchy and poppy and, you know what I mean? They
did Stacy's Mom or something, right?
Yeah. No. That was Fountains of Wayne.
Oh.
They did you have to go back, and I can't think of right now what the Bowling for Soup did. They did like one of the songs that was on the radio, but all right. It's in the same vein as Fountains of Wayne. You know, they kind of sound the same, right?
Got it.
But yeah, that's my number one because it just gets stuck in my head, dude. When I hear it, it's just like, well, there it is. It's stuck in my head for 2 days, so I know it's working, right? I know the advertising's working at that point.
You are locked in.
Yeah, so that's my number one.
All right, brother. Well, do I have a number one?
Yeah.
Have I already done my number one, or did you go first?
I went first.
All right. Sorry, y'all. Okay, so my favorite one isn't a theme that I watched as a child. I was a teenager when I started watching the show, and this was well after watching films with the same individuals as the show. And in order to get to this wonderful land, one must walk in a ministry of silly walks. I'm talking about Monty Python and the Flying Circus.
All right.
I absolutely love that comedy troupe. The theme song to me is extremely British and extremely iconic. Yeah. And, you know, it's really my feel good song. I only have two or three that really can just flip me.
Instantly.
Yeah. Yeah. If I'm in a cross mood, I can just kind of trigger it and mellow out. It's just something about it. It brings levity and joy to me. And then again, it's a very long-lasting show with tons of episodes with lots of iconic characters. And, you know, I mean, we could have a whole Monty Python conversation, I suspect. But
yeah.
But I just want to limit it here to that show and that theme song.
Cool, man. Yeah. Awesome.
Nice.
It's one of those where I wouldn't know right off the bat of hearing it because I didn't watch enough of it, you know? I know the shows and I've seen them, but I wasn't an avid watcher. So, but I'm sure there's a lot of people out there are and they agree with you. Like, it's pretty self-evident that that's what it is when you hear it. So, yeah, dude, cool. I do like the troupe and I do like the movies and the I think the only thing that I've seen on TV by them was that the Ministry of Awkward Walking type of deal. I don't think I ever really watched anything else because I've seen like a lot of YouTube videos and stuff on that. So,
for sure.
Cool, man. Awesome. Right
on. You got yourself an honorable?
I do, and I had trouble breaking it down in between two. So I'm gonna do one. I'm gonna do two quick ones. If that's cool.
Fine. I'm gonna add one.
I'm not gonna talk too long about them, but my first quick one is the Power Rangers theme song.
Hey, sometimes you gotta go.
I mean, look at my hat. You know, like. I had to put that on there. It's one of my honorable mentions. It's the Power Rangers, man. And
that was a heavy theme song too for its day.
Yeah, dude, for sure. And the other one is, and because I didn't put this on here, because they've only been like six seasons of it. It's a fairly newer show. Is the Goldbergs, the theme for the Goldbergs.
I love that show. I truly love that show.
I always have to like sing a certain part of it when it comes on, and my wife's like, she always looks over at me like, "Are you gonna sing it? Are you gonna sing the part?" You say, you know what I mean? So it's become kind of our thing. So I had to sort of give an honorable mention to that and a shout out. So
you got to, brother.
Anyways, cool. That's my.
All right. Well, maybe another time I'll sing you my favorite theme song. But it ain't gonna be here. No. That can't possibly air.
Cool, man. Are we done?
You don't
want an honorable mention?
I did. I dropped the, didn't I?
No.
Oh, I didn't. Oh, I'll be damned. Well, I'm going to sing to you after all then. Okay. Will you be the Larry to the Balky Bartok Moose?
Oh, man. Perfect Strangers?
Perfect Strangers.
Huh? Oh, dude. He pulled that one out.
TGIF, man. It was always like I would sit through the you know, Full House and the Family Matters to get to Perfect Strangers, dog.
Oh, dude. Great show, right. Dude.
Right. Now I'm going to just give you a little bit.
Hit it. Let's go.
Sometimes the world looks perfect.
One eternity later.
Friend, sending out a deer, flab in the air.
All right, man. Well, if you guys enjoyed this episode, please contact us on our social media at Nerds on Lockdown, at Instagram and on Twitter at Lockdown Nerds, and on Facebook at Push Up Your Glasses. I am Chris. Once again, this is A.A. Ron. Say goodbye to the beautiful people, Aaron. Say goodbye.